making his way to the ring, weighing in at 323 pounds, Kane!
The big red machine, Kane, looking to continue his rivalry with the Wyatt family as he faces Luke Harper, Morinello, along with David Otunga, and the man that has kicked off Survivor Series more than any other superstar with 5 kickoffs, Mr. JBL, the longest reigning champion in SmackDown history.
And in 2005, I was part of Team SmackDown. They defeated Team Raw. Looking forward to our brand being the dominant brand again now.
Exactly right. You're a good luck charm, JBL.
And his opponent, weighing in at 275 pounds, Luke Harper.
Member of the Wyatt family, Luke Harper, who said that the world had put him to sleep, but now he is wide awake and he has seen the light, the new Wyatt family looking to run roughshod over SmackDown Live, beginning with this man.
Yeah, Kane was the one that took part of the downfall because of Randy Orton, who decided to side with the Wyatt family. The one that got left out in the cold was obviously Kane. Kane has a little chance at retribution against Luke Harper tonight.
I'm sure Kane feels some kind of way about Randy Orton. Definitely has to feel used. I mean, I don't think anybody saw that coming from Randy Orton.
With this match here tonight at Survivor Series, Kane equals his brother of destruction, The Undertaker, with his 18th appearance. Luke Harper looking to spoil that stat as Harper and Kane renewing hostilities here tonight on Survivor Series kickoff.
Yeah, a lot of great histories here. I remember back in 2004, Booker T is here, who I defeated in 2004 in a title match. Just thought I'd bring that up because my friend, the Hall of Famer, Booker T's over there, and he's listening to it, and he can't respond right now.
I'm certain he's very excited that you just brought that up.
Kane also making history at Survivor Series in the lone ambulance match against Shane McMahon back in 2003, but now he has his hands full with Luke Harper, but there's a big shoulder tackle by the big red machine.
You know, Kane has to feel almost like a little bit like he's looking in a mirror here at a younger version of himself. I think Luke Harper has often been said he could be the most dangerous member of the entire Wyatt family. That is saying something very impressive about Luke Harper.
And has drawn favorable comparisons to legends like Bruiser Brody and others. Of course, speaking of big men, want to send out positive thoughts to Big Van Vader. Keep up the good fight. Of course, so many legendary superstars at Survivor Series, and Kane and Luke Harper looking to make their mark.
Yeah, the big thing about Frank Brody was that great athleticism that Bruiser had, and that's how what reminds so many people of Luke Harper, of the legend himself, Bruiser.
David,
I don't know if I've ever seen somebody who moves like Luke Harper does for that size. Sometimes I wonder if he realizes how big he is.
And I was going to say, Kane still has his strength taking the big man down like that.
Yes, he does. Kane, one of the strongest superstars in WWE, and he moves pretty well himself.
Now look at the pure size of Kane. Luke Harper is a huge man, and he's dwarfed by Kane.
I've been in the ring with Kane many times, and I fancy myself to be pretty strong. But going up against him, I mean, it's like trying to move a mountain.
Hammerlock and driving that left shoulder into the corner is Kane on Luke Harper. Continues to work over the left arm. Kane saying that he should have never trusted Randy Orton because he's a snake, he's the Viper. But he's also said that he will not sleep peacefully until he eliminates the new Wyatt family.
Oh, a snake bites you, whose fault is it? It's a snake, that's what they do. I think it's to be expected of Randy Orton. However, I've known Randy and his father since Randy is probably 10 or 12 years older, known of Randy. I never dreamed he would do something like join the Wyatt family.
Oh, and here's a top head suicida by Luke Harper.
That's exactly what I'm talking about right there. A man his size jumping through the ropes like that.
Talk about a jumbo jet taking off in Toronto. Luke Harper throwing caution to the wind.
Wow.
Sent on a Domico by Harper, and it results in a two count. So
this Harper is just deceptively agile.
Oh, the wow! Kick right to the face of Kane. Oh, Kane kicks out. Luke Harper controlling Kane here on Survivor Series kickoff. Former WWE Intercontinental Champion Luke Harper grounding Kane. And this is what transpired before the break.
Yeah, something you certainly don't expect out of someone the size of Luke Harper, but that's what exactly makes Luke Harper so dangerous.
And that's exactly what he needs to do with Kane here, because Kane clearly wasn't ready for that. And obviously Kane can match power with Harper, but he can't match that kind of agility.
Harper continuing to attack the area right between the shoulder blades with those clubbing forearms, now with that rear chin lock employed on Kane, looking to sap his strength.
And just riding Kane here. You got a big man down like this, whatever you do, don't let him up. And that's what Luke Harper is doing his best to do, is keep Kane under control.
That's easier said than done with this big red monster.
Yes, it is.
A series of knee drops by Luke Harper. Acquitting himself well here in singles competition. A member of the new Wyatt family.
And this.
And he is going all the way. Looked like he was going to go all the way to the top, but he just got rocked with that right uppercut by Kane.
And that's the thing, you got to stay on Kane because he just keeps getting up.
Man, this is like King Kong and Godzilla in the Empire State Building. What's going to happen here?
This doesn't end well.
Superplex by Kane on Luke Harper.
Clearly shook Harper up, but what kind of damage did it do to Kane?
One, two.
And you see Luke Harper took the brunt of that on his upper shoulders and back of his neck.
Yet he's the first back up to his feet.
Oh!
Oh. But it's Kane that clutches his neck. And Kane running over Luke Harper.
This is the fear that Luke Harper had to have the whole time, is you don't want to let this big red monster get rolling. And that is exactly what Kane is doing right now.
Series of body avalanches and a sidewalk slam. Cover, oh, and a near fall there for Kane on Luke Harper.
Kane playing the part of Rick Grimes, taking down the Walker.
Oh! And he just got taken down with that big back kick by Harper. And Kane escapes it too. Hard hitting, highly competitive affair here between Kane and Luke Harper.
Kane Look at coming this. Off that rope, trying to do something. Did not expect the athleticism of Luke Harper. Again, that is the shocking thing about this big man.
Sends Kane into the corner. Kane responds with a big boot to the face. Now a full head of steam.
Whoa, drop kick.
A drop kick by Harper. Side press, hooks, a leg, and at the last second, Kane able to lift that left shoulder.
What can't Luke Harper do? Golly.
Right now, he can't find a way to beat Kane, but he may find out pretty quick.
And look, Kane's coming right back up. This is that resiliency.
Yeah, and Harper proving to the cruiserweights that, you know, he can fly too, as he's definitely taken to the airways, but now a roll up here by Harper on Kane. Oh, but Harper walked right into the big boot of Kane. DDT by the big red machine. Could this be it?
One,
two. And Harper this time rolling that right shoulder. It's going to come down to who makes that critical mistake. Two veterans here in WWE looking to get the better of each other on Survivor Series kickoff. Oh! Swinging sidewalk slap there, and Kane able to escape again.
How close was that?
The diabolical denizen of the swamp against the big red machine.
Look at those eyes.
Get ready for this discus clothesline.
Oh, nope. Instead, it's a choke slam from Kane. Choke slam by Kane. And that's it for Luke Harper.
Here is your winner, Kane.
In his record-tying 18th appearance at Survivor Series, Kane emerges victorious.
Yeah, and I would say better than ever. Paul Kane all through the Attitude Era, all through the 2000s till I retired, and this big man keeps going and just keeps getting better and better and better. And a path of destruction keeps following Kane.
And the 30th Annual Survivor Series promises to be in fuego, especially with action like this, David.
And this kick out of nowhere from Luke Harper. It's one of the things that makes him hard to match up against. And then using Kane's own momentum against him. Look how close this, just barely getting his shoulder up, was Kane. Ultimately, that choke slam just proved to be too much for Luke Harper.
The big man keeps rolling.
Kane got to celebrate SmackDown Live 900 with his brother in destruction, The Undertaker, celebrating a big win here tonight on the Survivor Series kickoff.